are live action, brought to you in part by the pink color yellow and the number 12. Welcome back. Nobody quite yet, but we are back with NASCAR 21 Ignition Career Mode Part 3, Roush Redemption. Currently on the season, we have one win, three top fives.
We're here on the West Coast for our abbreviated West Coast Swing. I'm Alex Hayden, and Las Vegas plays host to one of our
brother
two
Joe,
West Coast races this early in the
season. Sister
Nathan,
the weather
is absolutely perfect as the teams prep for this very fast 1.5-mile racetrack. Handling is going to be the big talk this weekend. Who can keep their car wound up the most?
Already starting out great with a freeze.
This package changes the field.
Straightened out. I didn't mean to skip my guy, Alex Hayden.
We're just going savage mode right now on us.
See if the setup stays in the car. Let's get this in practice. Whoa, there
oh,
no,
dude.
Turns. Holy.
Door, bro.
I think Las Vegas is one of those tracks that they don't really lift that, so it's going to be about maintaining momentum. Staying in the draft, arcing into the corners. Greasy! Feeling pretty good at practice here, but I'm sure it's gonna get tight as a motherfucker in the draft. Thank you. pretty good in practice. Look at my disgusting crew chief. Let's get the qualifying there, bud. Fastest lap in qualifying out of 26 cars.
Qualifying day here in Las Vegas. I'm Alex Hayden, here to bring you the biggest gambling of the weekend. We're not talking about dice, but how risky these drivers will be with their throttle inputs. With this package, Las Vegas is known for being able to run right on the edge and be nearly wide open all the way around the track. Who'll keep the throttle down today to put themselves on pole? Team Penske and Ford have had unrivaled success here lately, but there's plenty of other drivers in this field looking to put their name at the top of the pylon and show that they have the speed and the handling to go win this race this weekend. Will Team Penske continue their dominance starting with qualifying, or will a new team take over the prime spot? Let's go trackside and find out.
You only got half health. You got full health. What you doing? You're stuck. Get on them. Get on them.
Hopefully the setup stays loose, but I doubt it.
Dummy, bro, or what, dude? Are you like? Oh, nice, I got one. Oh, and then Thor showed up.
I love how it randomly drops 20 fucking miles an hour at the start finish in my fucking qualifying lap because you can't do an out lap on your own. Fucks your qualifying up every time. I don't know if it's just me. Has happened every single race, right? He's going 171 at the start finish, drops down to 159. No reason. Yeah, it's a last place qualification. It's a second and a half slower than what I ran in fucking practice because, again, you can't do your own outlap according to this game, you know, because the human can't control the car.
Alex Hayden here, welcoming you to Las Vegas Motor Speedway for the Pennzoil 400 presented by Jiffy Lube. This is a high-speed mile-and-a-half track located right next to Nellis Air Force Base.
Just another one of my fucking problems with this stupid shit. Set to start in 40th every single race because it does not let you properly qualify.
At least you can look at the crew chief.
Yeah, right, that functions properly. I might have to just change it from fucking, like, single session qualifying to set, like, the full ass regular stage call, whatever the fuck they call it. You can see them following each other, like, you just look up ahead and you see, yep, that's how that guy pokes out. It makes the racing really predictive. Had a Coral of Joy here. Working our way into the top 35. I'm pretty quick on the back there. Gets out of the way. On the big grid, we're good. Better on day 3. Get in or get into it! get some clean air here to start letting some fog on Max. Yo, what's going on, John? Appreciate you coming out. I don't know why the fucking car just got so tight in there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's about a second behind this big pack up here. Making good time on him, though. Oh, yeah. Coming up on him. Oh yeah, great 1 and 2. Making big time. Coming behind Josh Balicki here. Oh, I thought I could hold on up there. We had a massive run coming out of 3. Oh my god! Eric Jones up there going insane, pushing it 3 wide. Holy shit. We'll push it 3 wide. We'll push it 3 wide. Coming up 3. Oh, sliding up the track a bit. Carrying way too much speed on the bottom there. Car there. Getting into Ryan Preece a bit. Let's get up here behind Eric Almirola, Chase Briscoe, Matt DiBenedetto. Massive run down into 1. Jump way out of it. Oh, Eric! The high side is working for us really well here. Right now we're racing against Ross Chastain in the points. He's second overall in points right now at 96. So we definitely want to be ahead of him. Lap 12 out of 40. Position 22. Making a solid run through the field so far. Car handles really well in the draft. Nice and stable in the corners. A lot faster than Ryan Blaney through 3 and 4. Holy shit. There's snow pulling.
What you got?
I got a swamp ball. Swamp ball rash. Oh, very lit, Brother John. No class till 12:30, that's what you like to hear. Nice chill morning. As you can see, I ain't got shit going on, so I'm grinding some NASCAR career mode. catching up to Bubba Wallace here in the top 20. Running really, really well so far. Oh, coming up on Bubba with a full head of steam. Gonna slide up here and smash the wall. That would make sense. I have him turned down pretty far. That guy Joe is pretty loud sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah. He do like to yell and shit.
Mm-hmm. And just, his microphone is like really quiet and then just gets crazy loud. Yeah, it's a tough balance, John, because the audio in this game sucks fat horse wieners. Well, he's crashing with the sunhouse. You can't really hear the cars too well, or the car audio cuts in and out pretty aggressively sometimes, so I want to be able to still hear that. And besides, you don't want to hear nothing stupid in the same way.
Yeah, yeah, it says like the same three things.
Almost. Almost. I saved it. He's redone. That's what he means.
Watch your mouth.
The neighbor tried to.
Throwing touchdowns.
I'll keep the Discord real quick.
Nice.
Yeah. One tap.
Got it. Bobby Milkers.
Let's kill the shit. Let's kill the shit. Yo, also stream, just so you know, we probably are going to be streaming some Warzone a little bit later on this afternoon here. As you're watching NASCAR 21 Railroad Edition. As everybody is running the exact identical line. Look at this. Look at this.
Oh my god.
Wow, I wonder what line they're going to take in a turn one. Oh, the exact one they took last time.
Someone's saying, let's get this shit.
Oh, they're also all running the exact same speed. No way. I don't know how to scale career mode difficulty. I turned it up to champion, and I just ran from 40th to 10th in 18 laps. I don't know if career mode difficulty is set on its own thing, and they turn it up or down or whatever, but...
Why not just go with option B? You're just better.
I'll take that, too, but usually I'm not.
So what, your trash can?
No, but it's just not usually this easy to run from 40th to first. I just gotta restart the race 7 or 8 times and crash into somebody in every time and yell about the game 5 or 6. We're about to just catch up to Kyle Larson here and fuck him up.
Wreck him. Dump him.
I'll tell you what though, graphically it does look a little bit better today. The cars are still kind of mad, but like some of the pop-ins and the load-ins and shit.
Mary Poppins?
Am I actually going to race these top three up here? I'd love to race Kyle Busch and Kyle Larson.
They can't handle the speed of JRT. Fuck you, boy.
Yeah, there's no way the difficulty is that.
He's just got sloshed on.
And they're running in a draft. And I just...
You're just faster. And break it down from a fundamental aspect to their speed and then their god speed. You run on demon speed again. Yeah. Not even the holy speed can catch up to you.
Say this though, at Homestead, I was a top 15 car, and then they all started pitting towards the end, and I was blessed with the second place. So I the difficulty is up there because I track my phone so bad on the apps.
Is NFM series staying on Heat, or is he gonna switch to?
NFM
FM series is probably going to be postponed for a little while, like porting over to this game because there's no private lobbies yet. Once there's private lobbies. The car is getting ridiculously tight now that I'm in the so well happy these guys. Going 5 mile an hour slower into the corner. And it is just. It is pushing up the track. So, don't do any adjusting. Jesus Christ. It's just magnetized to the wall. The car is just pushing so hard.
Me too.
He's doing the same thing at Homestead. In the draft. Now it's just doing it. Yeah, super tight on that gear. Holy shit. It's loose. It's not even loose in. It's like stable in, tight off.
Pronounced bang as a mash.
It would.
Bang.
Bang. Damn, look at all them Kyles, bro.
Amped up on Monster and Race Fuel. And there's Timmy.
Timmy?
Yeah, out of four cars, just terribly tight. One driver is tight.
Get new wheels. New tires.
Not fucking Timmy.
Dude, I ain't doing that. Do whatever. Blow in the hammer.
Catching up to the back of the pack here. Put 6 seconds on Larson.
Yeah. He's just, weight balance it. Better.
28 to 40. 13 to go.
It's easy race.
I don't remember where we go to next. I'm gonna be for a short track of the year. I'm not entirely sure. Win number two of the career, though, looks like coming pretty handily. I'm gonna put some guys a lap down. Look, oh, there's Brendan Gaughan, Dave Reagan. These guys should start the race. Started the race now.
Kids literally just stood up there. It's faster in every aspect.
Except when the car just does not want to turn out of that fucking corner.
Yeah. What am I supposed to do? I promise you.
Dude, when I tell you my left stick is pushed so hard to the left there, and I'm not on the gas, and the car just does not turn.
just not having it.
It's like at fucking Homestead. I gotta do 110 and fucking go around the corner and just got smashed up in the fucking wall. I don't know if that's like dirty air or the tires falling off. Usually when the tires fall off, you don't push, you fucking slide, but... And if it's dirty air, that's really, really aggressive dirty air. But it was doing that shit when I had no draft on me, so I don't know.
Called greasy air.
I'm just guessing it's tire fall off.
When you riding that thing?
Yeah. Just doesn't fucking turn unless I'm doing 140 at the bottom of the drag.
Hey, yo, is my guy's last name Alfredo Sauce?
No.
That says Alfredo.
Yeah, that's not Sauce.
Yeah, the Alfredo Sauce.
Oh, look at him pitting. Oh, look at him dying in the infield.
Damn, the whole field just went pit.
And the whole field just got lapped. Oh, hey, Denny.
Bunch of fools.
Well, lost 2 seconds a lap on tires since the start, so that's definitely what it is. Tire fall off. It's looking like another race where we don't got fit.
Yeah,
oh! God, that was close. Oh, here comes Denny. Look at how much faster fresh tires are. Holy shit, I passed him a lap and a half ago. Well, so you can, I mean, Eric Jones is blocking the shit out of him now, but he just came zooming up on me. Yeah, I just don't have the traction they do in the corner. That is the tire fall off. Oh boy. Oh, we got a wreck. Oh, Eric Jones is dead! Oh! Oh my god!
Oh. Dang, son. Trying to take your ass out, bud. Well, what the hell, bud?
Eric Jones dead! Oh, tragic scenes out of some of this motor speedway today. Holy.
Dead as hell, boy.
Oh, God, it's really tight. The tires are gone. White flag this time by, white flag this time by. White flag presented by Helix Credit One Bank.
Boy, what the hell, boy?
We have no speed in the corners, but it doesn't matter because the whole field is a lap down, Bubba. Car's looking a little janked up there, partner. Oh, there's Alex Bowman. Okay, my fault, my fault. Ross Chastain, yeah. Well, he ran top 20 today. That's good. I gained a couple points on him today. Dub number two.
Easy.
Win number two of the season.
Dude, they don't even understand.
Put the whole field a lap down.
Oh, just quite literally yeah. Different.
We're going to Phoenix. This is where I get my ass kicked. This is going to be a bad run. For sure. For sure. The Instacart 500.
Welcome to Phoenix Raceway, where we finish up the West Coast swing. I'm Alex Hayden, and this track, with its removal of grass back in 2011 and reconfigured start-finish line in 2018, has gone through some major overhauls to get to where we are today. The changes have created some intense multi-groove action and ultimately led NASCAR to choose Phoenix as the Cup Series finale. Each end of this track is completely different, with less than 10 degrees of banking in turns 1 and 2, and then 10 to 11 degrees of banking in 3 and 4. The infamous dog leg provides options to fan out and cut the track before funneling off into turn 1. Drivers will be looking to make their cars capable of running these different lines and be able to put the power down on corner exit.
Let's see how bad I am at Phoenix this year. I'm dog shit at Phoenix and heat games. So we could be looking at a top 20 here, maybe even a top 30. It could be very, very rough scenes. Whoa. I love the way they start you out on the track. I love that so much.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Just let me drive out of the pit, bro. Let me do my outlap. Let me warm my fucking car up. I don't understand why it has to fucking just start you driving out the fucking course. The guy doesn't know how to control the fucking car.
Get the fuck out of the way! Pulling the track doing 2 fucking miles an hour, you stupid prick.
Hayden here to bring you qualifying at Phoenix Raceway. This oddly shaped 1 mile track features a dogleg area on the front stretch that produces some insane. Despite Chase Elliott winning the 2020 championship from the back, this track is notoriously hard to pass with a low degree of banking. Today is about giving yourself the advantage out of the gate with good track position. Starting on the inside is also ideal, as you'll have the opportunity to cut that dogleg and potentially send it into turn one. Which driver takes advantage? Let's find out.
I hope we're going to try and take advantage of qualifying, but I don't think the car is going to be too good. Top 13, all right. Decent fucking qualifying run there.
Yes, sir. Back at.
Decent little start here.
Welcome
at Phoenix.
To Avondale, Arizona for the Instacart 500. Alex Hayden here bringing you all of the action from today's duel in the desert. We're expecting a lot of great side-by-side racing, and the infamous dogleg in the front stretch has given us some of the most incredible restarts in 3, 4, and 5 wide passes in recent NASCAR history.
All right, here's the thing. Alex Hayden is talking way too much about this fucking dogleg in every intro. How much money do you want to bet that not a single one of the AI touched the dog leg at some time? I can almost guarantee not a single one was on the dog leg. Not a single time. Are you ready for a massive checkup? And we're on the inside. Great start. Car just won't turn again. Just a constant struggle at every track because you can't put a setup in it because you just can't. The setup bar won't even save the setup slider thing, so the car just pushes so hard at every track and every corner. Thank you. just, I need the car to turn. No front grip whatsoever. Top 10 here, 47 laps, long race. Can Ricky Stenhouse here. Got a little groove here. Looks like Larson fell back a couple spots, lost a couple positions. Is just so outrageously tight right there. Just can't seem to break this little bit of a gap between Chase Elliott.
Are you racing?
Where am I racing? Phoenix. Take three passes on the front stretch right there like that. No cap. Up into the top five with that right there. It's like Blaney and Larson are fucking with each other a little too much. I was able to just slip by. Now we got to catch Martin Truex, Denny Hamlin, and Joey Logano.
Good. That's a little lead.
Yeah, he's looking pretty quick up there. Got a second and a half on Martin. He got a second on me. It's like three of my least favorite people in the whole entirety of NASCAR out here right now. It's like they got a little checkup right there at the start finish. Heard Denny get out of the gas a bit. I should have got out of the gas way more, apparently. Joey's catching up to lap traffic. I'm running on my outside here, which I don't like going into turn right this thing. Big lag. See how the leader deals with lap traffic.
He's already lost a second. Did he try and get around him? Nope, he just runs the exact same way. So.
Of course.
Like he's a last card. Wow. Wow, okay. Well, that's that. End of the lead at Phoenix here.
Driver AI on spectacular.
Difficulty's turned up too. I'll show you. I'm one below the max difficulty. That I could not put the gas. Get on the gas at all. A lot of space between me and Joey currently. Just doing negative 12 miles an hour into a fucking turn.
Digging this up.
Love how the Toyota sign looks like the Hollywood sign.
Yeah, right? Car's doing very good. A little tight, but that's usual. Coming up behind Tour of the Joy, BJ McLeod. Just so outrageously fast.
Yeah, kids just can't hang with you. It's like lightning between speed on this racetrack right now. Look, there you look.
Fuck! I didn't have to do that. Giving the bumper to everybody.
Dump him!
Now, I don't want to cause a caution and crash my game. If it actually decides to throw a caution. Well, that's cool. They got like the little sticker things in the bottom left there. That actually like, peel the windshield off when it gets too dirty. Wow,
absolute cruising time.
Oh, you're making assumptions. If people don't have off days.
Still grinding out, I see good stuff. Must be nice living off the government and playing games all day. Buddy, you don't know what the fuck you're talking about, pal. I think you know who the fuck I am, buddy. I'm living off the government. Driving that in from the wall to start soon, so that I'll drive down and get back in the
car. Must be nice being able to comment.
Yeah, you're the one sitting here on a fucking YouTube live stream commenting bullshit you know nothing about.
You can have jobs and still play games, bro.
Yeah, buddy. It's called working second and third shift, fucknuts. How about you eat shit and get the fuck out of my stream, loser?
Have a good day.
Sorry, you're on your lunch break and I'm out here having fun.
Some people just be hating. It be what it be.
Swamp, thanks for coming out, brother.
Who would it be? I feel bad for them people, bro.
Straight the fuck up. Dude watching YouTube says must be nice to live off government. Exactly, Swamp Ball.
That's what I'm
dude
saying,
needs to like man. Do a 360 mirror evaluation of himself real quick and fucking actually decide what the fuck he's doing. Oh, fuck.
That's what I'm saying.
Bro acts like also real quick. Bro acts like the government is the most holiest, highest standard, fucking greatest thing ever in the whole entire world. If I want to live off the fucking government, you goddamn right I'm going to. Fuck the government. Fuck you. Government's not going to do his due diligences and give an able-bodied person money for free? That's on the government.
yeah, that ain't my problem.
Nah. Straight the fuck up. Does that mean that I'm getting money from the government? Hell fucking no. Only time I get money from the government is my goddamn taxes.
Shit, and even then, sometimes you gotta pay it back.
Yeah, I'd be owing $60, $80 a year sometimes. Also, real quick, bro, how do you not know I'm not paralyzed from the waist down right now? Also, like, what if I'm sitting in my chair playing my game, living my life, trying to be fucking happy? What the fuck if I'm paralyzed from the fucking waist down or some shit? You just hopping here talking shit, assuming something.
He knows better.
That's crazy. I'm done with it, though. I'm not putting no more energy or talking about it anymore. I'm focusing on the race, which I'm getting pretty decent at. That's just crazy.
Yeah, so there was a shooting last night in the area.
Oh no.
Really? Mostly two people were injured. My mom asked me if I heard it last night. I did not.
Like,
there's
close?
Definitely a shooting. I'm looking on the map where it was right now. I can't figure out where I was on the map.
It's crazy. Yeah, I mean, we got shootings out here in Pittsburgh.
Where's Market Street? Where?
Old Slima out here be
Slima, bro.
You're getting crazy. Nah, Slime, I'm not really paralyzed from the waist down, but I'm just saying, like, people like that on the internet just be assuming shit and saying shit, talking out of their ass for no reason. Like, dude.
Ikeda has a disfigured left foot, though.
I do, yeah. I did crush my foot with a forklift one time. That was not a good
experience. Oh, there's deals for college. Oh, here we are. Yeah, this happened like at least 5 miles away from my crib. How did my money get here?
That's crazy, yeah.
Definitely shooting me. Yo, Swampo, we know this kid. That's a midget, and he somehow turned out to be a police officer.
Yeah, facts.
Kid can't even ride the rides with the roller coaster.
Actually, fashion.
There's a whole ride cat.
Yeah, shout out our guy Eric.
No shout outs.
I know you're keeping the peace and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
And more like keeping a piece of the action for himself. You know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Especially out there at the University of Tennessee, you know he's keeping a little piece tucked away. Come on, man. Ten laps to go, 11 laps to go, 9 laps to go, whatever it is.
A water.
Very, very fast compared to the field. Whole field about to be lapped. Oh, send her into the outside wall a little bit here. Oh, we're gonna kill that guy. Almost killed. Yep, just use everybody up. Fuck it. Coming about 5 to go here. Running pretty good, feeling pretty good. Ran a lot better than I thought. I wish I was more like racing the AI and not so much just passing. Well, Joey's caught up to me quite a bit. There's only 2.7. had this Miles lock up the right bumper. Something was smoking out of the car. Didn't look too good. Oh, Kyle Busch. Kyle Busch back here in 19. Gonna catch himself a lap. Dog leg OP. Just passed four cars. And like I said, not a single car using the dog leg. White flag presented by Helix Credit One Bank. Win number three of the season, win number two in a row.
Oh, great run today.
Quality 13th, right up through the field.
I don't remember putting Joey Logano two laps down. That doesn't make sense to me. Definitely lap Chase Elliott once, but.
Yeah.
Well, two laps down. Yeah, that
makes sense. Joey should not have been a lap down. He was right behind me.
Alright, so I'm take a look at the old standings here. Man, I can't believe I'm really just sitting here reading that. Must be nice living off the government and playing games all day. Who the fuck is that guy, man? Unbelievable. Take a look at the point standings. We are P1, 187 points, 5 stars, 3 wins, 5 top 5, 5 top 10s, 81 laps led, 15 playoff points. $2.7 million in winnings this year so far. Looking very, very nice. Three unique winners this year. Roush family leading the owners points. I think. Oh, no. Well, yeah, leading the owners points. We are second in team points. And we are last in manufacturers points. This is Toyota is amazing. Peep the reputations here. Up to a 40 reputation with Roush. 20% with Chip Ganassi Wood Brothers and 23XI. There's all that. Our reputation has gone down with Hendrick, probably because I'm racing those guys real roughly.
Brother Eaton.
Yeah. I think we're going to call it there, guys. Did two races, got two wins in a row. We're calling good there. We'll be back tomorrow. We will be back tomorrow morning with part 4 of the NASCAR Twinway Ignition Career Mode Series, Roush Redemption. I want to thank you guys for coming out. Make sure you drop a like, comment, subscribe. Ring the bell notification, we're notified each and every single time us government mooching loser rats go live with brand new content. I'm just kidding. Make sure you hit that bell notification, that way you're notified each and every time Helix goes live with brand new top-notch content. Thank you so much, guys. This has been Helix. My name is Jason, and we will catch you. Peace.